I really want to help you, so I'm going to tell you the truth. Excuses are for wimps. Oh, and I used to be a wimp when it came to food. You could put me in front of an angry, hostile crowd overseas, and they could say, Dr. Brown, it's very dangerous. Your life might be threatened. Preaching. It's like, I don't care. Put me out there and preach. And then you serve me some food I've never seen. It's like, I don't want that. I was a wimp when it came to food. Oh, but I had my excuses. And you know, it's interesting when you look at the ministry of Jesus. He's full of compassion, full of grace, full of long-suffering, but he never tolerated excuses. Luke 9, 57 to 62, he demolishes the excuses of the would-be followers. So one day, in my old days of unhealthy eating, I was working out with some friends, and the trainer that was pushing us, a friend of ours, had volunteered some time, and he was saying, you know, 90% of your abs and all that, it's the kitchen, it's not the working out. And then I explained to him, yeah, I know that, I understand it, but you know, my schedule's crazy. I travel around the world, you know, get off the plane and preach after traveling for 40 hours. You know, you're at airports, you don't really have a choice of what you eat, you're on the planes and so on. And then you're overseas, you gotta eat what they said before you and so on and so forth. And there was a great set of excuses. I mean, they were airtight. The next day we're working out, and there's a guy, one of our grads from our ministry school, he's working out too. And the trainer's giving him the same little speech about healthy eating, and he begins to give his excuses. Well, he and his wife, with the ministry work they do, get home, it's a hurry, they just have time, eat something quick, they don't, you know, can't prepare properly. Sometimes they gotta get fast food on the road. And I listened, I thought, that's the weakest set of excuses I ever heard, man. If you wanna change, you can change. And I thought, uh-huh. So my excuses sounded so powerful and weighty to me, and his excuses sounded so miserable and weak to me. Friends, stop making excuses. When I realized I had to make a radical change, because here I was 59 years old, I'm big, almost 6'3", but I weighed 275 pounds, I had high blood pressure, I was tired. I sat down with my wife, Nancy, and I said, I don't know how long I can keep doing this, my travel schedule and all that. She'd never heard me talk like that, because I'm always enthused. Today's good, tomorrow's gonna be better. And I came to the point, I said, honey, I said, something has to change. I said, my plan's not working. I have to do something radically different. And she said, no food passes through your lips without my permission. I'm gonna tell you what to eat and what not to eat. But I realized, all the excuses were going nowhere. I had to come to that point of recognizing it's on me, change can come. I had to travel all around the world, crazy schedule after that. We made choices to live it out, and I have been flying high ever since.